Hello, I'm Natasha Belling and welcome to 10's Evening News. First tonight, mandatory life sentences look set to be introduced for anyone who murders a New South Wales police officer. The plan's been welcomed by the father of a young constable brutally killed in the line of duty. But some say it could make juries less likely to convict.
It's among the most unconscionable of crimes, snatching away the life of those who risk it all to protect us. Perhaps now some will think twice.
Those who murder police will be locked up for life. No ifs, no buts, no maybes.
12 New South Wales police officers have been murdered in the line of duty since 1970, among them John Carty's son, David. The 25-year-old constable was savagely bashed and then stabbed in the heart by a gang of men in Sydney's West in 1997.
David was attacked by at least 25, I call them men, but they're vermin from hell as far as I'm concerned.
Mr. Carty believes this law might have saved his son's life.
But it certainly would have given them something to think about. I'd like to think that it would have made a difference to either David living or dying.
This is a great day for the men and women of the New South Wales Police Force and their families.
The law would apply to anyone convicted of murdering a police officer while on duty or afterwards as a revenge attack. It would take effect regardless of whether the person knew or ought to have known their victim was in the force.
Resistance to this proposal is grounded in the belief that it may actually trigger a lower rate of conviction. Civil libertarians argue there is strong evidence to suggest juries will be less likely to return a guilty verdict when they know they'll be condemning the accused for life.
Should we have mandatory life sentences for granny killers? Should we have mandatory life sentences for people who kill ambulance drivers? That sort of thing. I mean, is one life worth more than another?
The legislation will go before Parliament this week. Matt Doran, 10 News.